imagination. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the head of Mini USA, Jim McDowell.
Thanks. Thank you. It's a real pleasure to be here today with you in Southern California. You may not realize it, but California alone is a huge mini market. We sell about one-fifth of our cars here in California that we sell in the United States. And that's enough minis that you rank up there in the same ranks as entire markets that have small car cultures. Markets like France and Spain and Japan. Well, Mini feels really at home in California without a doubt. I mean, you are a state that has such a tradition of blazing the way forward. You have opinion leaders, you have thought formers, you have a unique and expressive car culture. Of course, Mini is very much at home here. Well, 2007 has been a very good year for Mini. We introduced our new Mini hardtop in February. That was an all-new car with new engines, new suspensions, new transmissions, completely new. And our sales are up 5.7% this year. And that means that we're looking at what will probably be our best year ever, and that we'll probably top 40,000 sales this year. So it's a very good year, and we're excited about it. Another reason that we're excited is that we introduced our certified pre-owned program this year. It's called Mini Next, and we've already sold our 1,000th Mini Next car. And speaking of records, this summer, we delivered the 200,000th Mini to a U.S. customer, and that went to Scott Clayman. He got a red Cooper S convertible. He traded in a motorcycle and a sidecar for that, so don't you think that's a special 200,000th customer? Well, Mini has won a lot of accolades in 2007, and I'd just like to briefly share them with you. They all involve value. Mini's a good value when you buy it. Mini turns out to be a real and good investment when you sell it. And it's a good value for the person that gets it after you. The first award is the Strategic Vision Total Value Index Award. That says, what do you get for the money that you spend on a car? And Mini has won its category for this award every year since the car has been introduced. We've won it 6 years in a row. No other manufacturer has a string anywhere close to that. And because the convertible is in its own separate category, it has also won an award every year since it's been introduced for 3 years in a row. Now, value after you've had the car means what's it worth when you go to sell it? And both Kelley Blue Book and Automotive Lease Guide agree, Mini has the highest resale value in the industry, and we keep that ranking every year, so it's not a one-time achievement, it's something that's always there. And then our brand new Mini Next program has received an award from IntelliChoice as being one of the best certified pre-owned programs. So talk about an amazing car. It's good value when you drive it, it's good value when you sell it, and it's even good value for the person that buys it after you. So from that perspective, it's quite a record for us. Well, and in 2007, we've been hard at work on our business. Our dealers have been expanding their facilities because they have a lot more Mini customers than we would have expected at this point in our history. We're expanding our network from 82 dealers to about 95 over the next 3 years. And about 60% of those new points will bring Mini to parts of the United States where we haven't previously been represented. Now, the factory has continuously been making investments to expand their production capacity. There's just more demand for Minis worldwide than they can build. And also, we've been investing in the product. Every year over the last 4 years, Mini has had a major product introduction, and that pace is going to continue as we go forward. Now, on September 27th, you may have heard that our chairman made an announcement that there's going to be a fourth Mini. It will be a new segment that we will go into. It'll be a somewhat larger car, it will be a crossover vehicle, and it'll bring even more motoring joy to those of us in the United States. But you don't have to wait very long to see the next new Mini. In just a couple months, you're going to see a great and distinctive addition to our family, and it is the Mini Clubman, the other Mini. Now, have you seen an entrance like that before? Well, we really wanted to draw your attention to what is so unique and special about this new car. It's about 9.4 inches longer than a Mini hardtop. But what it has are five very unusual doors, and we want to share the whole news with you right now. It has five doors, but they're not exactly where you would expect them to be. For example, on the passenger side, there's a fairly conventional door for the passenger to get in the front seat. But if I want to have a friend join me, I open the club door, and you can see how easy the entrance is into the back seat. He didn't even fold the seat forward to do that. And the exit, just equally as easy. Thank you very much. And it's great for when you want to help people get in the back seat, you want to load your gear. It's just a really fun way to be able to have more functionality from the car. And when you have a chance later, listen to the thunk that this door makes. I mean, this is not any kind of minor modification to a Mini. It's a thoroughly engineered solution. Now, the man that was the original designer for Mini, Sir Alec Isagonis, said that he wanted as much functionality as possible in a vehicle that was as compact and small as possible. And I think he would have loved the Clubman, because let me show you the back of the car. Now imagine that you're coming up with a sport bag, a tennis racket, your briefcase. Well, it's very easy. You can just open one of the doors, and look, it even opens itself. You stow your stuff, and you're on your way. But imagine you have something a little bulkier that you want to take with you. Well, you open both sides, and in this case, it's really easy to get my board out. And then I hand it to my willing partner, and I'm all done with my unloading. Now, what we've got here are very unique doors. You can see they're basically hinged on the side. Look how they pull out from the car, giving a very wide opening where it's very easy to be able to put all of your stuff inside. And then also nicely finished doors. Look that you have storage compartments in the side. Okay, what does this mean in terms of space? Well, when you have the cover up, you have 9.2 cubic feet of storage space that's concealed. When you fold the seats forward, then you have 32.8 cubic feet of space. That's up about 8.8 cubic feet compared to before. And we have a nice flat floor, so it's very easy to load. It has a concealed compartment underneath it. So I think you can see that a lot is going on with the Clubman. Now, I don't know if you're going to be at all like the way that I will be when I get my first Clubman, but these doors are so cool. I'm going to be up at midnight just opening and closing them because it's so much fun to see how the door pulls out around the taillights. Well, the body is very unique and innovative, but that's not the whole story. Now, you may wonder, does a longer Mini drive like a Mini? Well, actually, its wheelbase is only about 3 inches longer. It still has the wheels at the corner. It has the bulldog kind of stance. So it drives like a go-kart, so you'll have every bit as much motoring fun in this Mini as you would in the hardtop. And you probably want to ask, well, what kind of motors do you have? What kind of motoring experience will I have here? Well, we have a choice of two. We have the Cooper, it's 118 horsepower, and even under the new rating system, gets 37 miles per gallon. So talk about a car where you can go off and have a lot of fun not worry about what your impact is on the environment, and the gas won't cost you much. But if you want to get there a little faster, there's the Cooper S as well. The Cooper S is 172 horsepower, goes from 0 to 60 in 7 seconds, still gets 32 miles per gallon. And imagine that you're trying to pass a truck on a two-lane road. Because it's turbocharged, it's got an overboost feature, and you can get 192 horsepower on demand to get around that truck. Now, you probably wonder, well, it's a small car. Is it going to be safe? Well, like all Minis, we have crumple zones, we have a steel safety cage. This Mini has 6 airbags, including 2 air curtains that protect you from side impacts, both in the front seat and the back seat. Also, our cars come with a wide array of safety equipment. The Clubman comes with standard DSC. It has really precise electric steering. And also, it has a whole host of braking features that enable you to maintain the car safely under control in any kind of evasive circumstances. Well, that's a lot in one car. It's a highly distinctive car. I think you can say it really stands out as we're attempting to demonstrate by showing you all the ways that the car opens. But you know what? We're just at the talking about the very tip of distinctiveness. Because on this car, you can make it personally your own. Now, I know people hear that a lot, but there are 80 a la carte options for how we could build your Mini. And you say, well, how significant could all these be? Fairly significant. We have 12 exterior colors. We have contrast roof colors. We have the contrast color for the C-pillar and the bumper. We have contrast in various patterns that your mirrors could be. We have a wide array of interior options and colors. We have really some good packages that make, if you don't want to spend a whole lot of time specifying your car, make it easy to get a great Mini. We have tire and wheel packages, and that is just the tip of the iceberg. Now let's talk about some of the fun electronic stuff. You can get this car with Sirius Radio with a lifetime subscription. Pay for it once and you never have to worry about it again. And a feature I'd sure want in Los Angeles, navigation system with real-time traffic updates. Has Bluetooth connectivity, iPhone and iPod connection directly into the sound system. It really has a wide array of things that you'd want on a car. And if it's still not distinctive enough, well, let's talk about things that you can do to further make your Mini your own. We have a wide array of accessories that can be installed either before or after delivery. I hope you'll look in the back of the exhibit at our John Cooper Works part of the building. And you'll see that there's a lot of John Cooper Works stuff that you can add to it to make your car especially cool, really suited for racing. Isn't that right, Fireball Tim? Okay, I just happened to see you there in the audience. And then we have things like ground effect packages. We have graphics that you can put on the roof. We have stripes. We have decals. We have interior trim. We have exterior trim packages. It really is a lot that you can do to make sure that your Mini is the only one like it in Southern California, let alone the world. How many independent combinations of these things are there? Well, we've calculated it as 150 trillion unique combinations. So who's going to want a Mini like this? Well, a person that really wants to have a distinctive car, one that really stands out among all the others in the parking lot. Or somebody that loves their Mini, but they just need a little more flexibility, a little more space. With this car being added to our lineup, you see Mini moving from the original hardtop, which in some people's minds created a cult, to a wide array of offerings that we really think of as a culture. So this car is an important addition to the Mini lineup, and I very much think you'll want to inspect it. Now, two important things I haven't told you. When this goes on sale, it goes on sale February 16th, 2008, and we started the presentation discussing value, pricing. The pricing for the Mini Cooper Clubman is $20,600, and for the Mini Cooper S Clubman, $24,100, and that includes a 4-year warranty, a $650 transportation charge, and 3 years of full maintenance. You have to admit, that's a tremendous value. So please come up, examine every one of the 5 doors, open and close them, and it only comes with one warning. The LA fire marshal was concerned about your safety. So we built this barrier so that the car couldn't possibly injure anyone when it backed out. Please be aware of this barrier when you're coming to look at the car, because I'm fully convinced we'll injure more people falling over the barrier than we're ever saved by building the barrier. But please come up, open and close all five doors, and experience the Mini Clubman, the other Mini.